Charlie Fuller. I'm part of the transportation team tonight.
Hey, I'm Ben. I'm just walking.
Hi, I'm Denise. I'm part of the support team.
Good evening. Tom Mellon, co-founder of the Frontline Guardians.
Hi, Tom O'Neill. I'm the descendant of Ezekiel Anderson, and thanks for showing up.
How you doing? I'm Specialist Leo Bridgewater. I'm a Trenton native, and I'm Tom's partner.
My name is Leo Bridgewater Jr., and I'm a private supporter.
There you go.
All right.
Hello, I'm Lashana Bridgewater, and I'm also a supporter.
David Gold from Frontline Guardians. I'm Nolan's partner.
Steve Jinjo, helper.
You know, you were showing me something's going on.
No, if you sleep, you can pull your Kevlar with your flashlight.
Sure. Yeah. Good evening and Happy New Year to everyone, 2017, as we approach the new year. And looking forward to some great things. But tonight, we're in Trenton, New Jersey. I'm here with my good friend, Marine Captain, 1st Division of the Marine Corps, Tommy O'Neill, Leo Bridgewater, an E-4 and EO specialist. He was over in Iraq back in 2005 when a lot of things were happening over there. But we're here in Trenton, and we're commemorating a very United States history, historic moment. And
to be able to walk in the footsteps of my ancestors who fought alongside George Washington.
Yeah. And we don't have to fight when we get there. That's a good thing.
It's all commemorative tonight, Tom,
guys,
right?
These guys had to fight when they got there. That was awful what they had to endure. But within 15 minutes of that surprise, we broke the King's 3 finest regiments within 15 minutes.
Wow.
We broke 3 of his finest regiments.
Incredible.
They just had no idea what the bedlam and chaos broke the ranks, and everybody ran away. It was a massive victory that propelled us forward.
And Tom, the courage, the patriotism that was exuded there, and that was, you know, many people laid their lives down so that we could be free in this beautiful country, the United States of America. Once again, another segment of a legendary part of history here that's being commemorated tonight, which makes me, one of the co-founders, along with my partner Dave Gould, of the Frontline Guardians, very proud to be here and proud to be friends with patriots and many other followers that are going to be commemorating this event tonight.
It's great to have your support, and it's great to, this city's very charming. You know, I spent the day yesterday with Neo. It's a very charming city. It has a lot of potential. The people in it, you know, on the history behind it, are so important in this country. And I think that people are going to kind of get a sense of how important this place is. You know what I mean?
All of our hopes were dashed in that action and trend. Said that, and we're talking about Trenton.
That's right.
We're more, you know, most people just know about George Washington crossing the Delaware. That's why they had it.
That's true. There was a lot more than just crossing the Delaware River.
Yeah. And so the story is like, you know, and this is one of the last stops for King George's money before he hit the pond.
That's true.
So when things happened here, The ripple effect went to the highest of highs on the other side.
Yeah. Incredible.
Yeah, really should.
Incredible. And awesome. This is our history, and this is everything that represents the United States of America and why we're land of the free and the home of the brave. This is Tom Mellon once again in Trenton, January the 2nd. As a matter of fact, my father, who served in the Normandy invasion, would have been 90 years old today. So, Dad, happy birthday to you. He's been gone for some time, but a lot of patriots, a lot of courage that kept our country together. And hopefully we can look forward to a lot of good things in 2017, Tom.
Yes, sir.
Well, we're his legacy. This is his legacy.
Once again, this is Tom Mellon on behalf of the Frontline Guardians, along with Dave Gould, our good friend Tom O'Neill, Leo Bridgewater, and many of our followers here. Thanks for joining us, and thanks for sharing in history here. United States history in Trenton, New Jersey. Be safe, stay well, and most importantly, God bless America.
Well, the purpose for General Washington to displace his forces out of here rapidly was due to the fact that he was concerned that his entire army would get intoxicated as a result of the amount of taverns that were in Trenton. I just found that out myself, but it makes sense. However, General Washington was a raider in the truest sense. He never attacked and occupied any positions. He would always hit and move. And that's essentially the same maneuver we're doing here tonight, is a very aggressive maneuver around the flanks of the 17th, the 40th, and the 55th Regiment. And that's it. So far, so good. The weather's great. It's going to get warmer every 2 hours by 1 degree. No rain. How you doing, Leo? Good?
Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm good.
And it's a lot better than... in Iraq. Different terrain and all that. But it's great. So, no issue.
Right.
So,
we appreciate your support.
Chestnut and Hamilton Avenue, Trenton, New Jersey. We're on our way heading toward the outskirts of Trenton. And as we leave the city, the entire way I've been reflecting on where we need to go as a community and the marching orders that we have. So with Tom's help and other veterans in the area, you know, we definitely can execute in a way that hasn't been done before. Look forward to expanding a little bit later.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're at obelisk number 3 here at Greenwood Cemetery, and it's very significant because, to me, because Ezekiel's uncle or part of his family, another Anderson, had a farm here, okay? And then actually, Ezekiel had a farm in Penn's Neck, which is right near the battlefield as well. So this piece here was Anderson property. So when we talk about Ezekiel Anderson, not only did he lead the Yankees from probably this point on to the battlefield, but the terrain they were using was property of the Andersons. So they wouldn't have been able to do this maneuver without that property. So it really goes, and then you think about that risk that they were taking with getting hung. You know, like imagine if it failed. Your grandfather's buried over here. Where, right over here?
On this side.
And what was he, Army?
Navy.
Korea, did you say?
World War II.
Oh, World War II, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Some crazy stuff since being on the ships and probably was he in the Pacific.
Math. He wasn't no cook. I come from a long line of men in my family who answered the call to service to this great country of ours. Both my grandfathers, World War II. My father, Vietnam, United States Marine Corps. My uncle Mike and Bayard, Special Forces, Vietnam.
Yeah, sure.
529 survivor, hand-to-hand combat.
Lee Sean, of course.
My cousin Lee Sean.
Yeah, went to high school.
West Point graduate, 1996.
Yeah. Remember that.
And bronze, you know, Silver Star or Bronze Star.
Yeah,
couple tours in Iraq too.
It's a real deal, man.
Mm-hmm. My grandmother, Rosie Ribbiter, Eastern Aircraft, 92 years old.
Wow.
She used to do the riveting on the
B-17s?
Yep, that were made out in Ewing.
Wow. Oh yeah,
at the old GM plant.
Yeah,
she worked there.
Point right at this point here is when Ezekiel Anderson and the general and the rest of the Continental moved directly across Nottingham football field right here, which I played on years ago, and then the other obelisk, which is about another 100 meters past the football field. That's where we're heading, and it's actually getting warmer, which is great. It's gotten warmer and the rain stopped, so we're all very happy about that. Okay, so we're at the fifth or sixth obelisk? The fourth, excuse me. And, you know, right now you can envision General Washington and the Yankees coming right this way, you know, right through Nottingham High School, continuing east, northeast. And you can only imagine what is going through everybody's head, you know, the total desperation about all of it. Then, of course, the weather was 20 degrees cooler, I would say. So, I don't know, it just got to have been terrifying. And fortunately, we don't have to go fight a battle like we talked about earlier, but we're going to definitely endure it. That's it. are currently at the Fifth Obelisk, and it's been a very pleasant trip so far. The temperature's great, there's no rain, and we've got about another 10 miles to go before the Princeton Battlefield, our objective. And we'd like to take a moment and recognize one of our participants by the name of Ben Warren. Ben, why don't you come on over here?
The Road Warrior Award goes to Ben. If you take a look at his feet, he is actually more reflective of what the Continentals were.
I didn't realize that until like the third obelisk.
You know, in terms of weather, it was about 20-something more degrees lower than it is now. And they were close to that.
And so we're all wearing...
He gets the Road Warrior Award because, I mean, I'm in my army issue cold weather boots with my Dr. Scholl inserts and thick boot socks and, you know, thermals and stuff like that. And
me too.
And Ben put us to shame.
Let's see how tough he is when we get to the field, though, at like, you know, like 10 miles. Seriously, let's
put in the backpack.
But anyway, Ben Warren, Ben's family has been here for 400 years.
Yeah, Burlington City, 1619, with Farnsworth, Bordentown, and then at some point into Princeton, probably about 150 years ago.
Ooh, I don't believe it. I think he was in Princeton
Ben
in 76.
Warren, the Warren family.
He's a Tory spy.
Awesome.
Shh, don't leave me.
All right, thank you. We're on to the next.
To move 5,000 men and the logistical, that type of to be able to do that feat, and everyone be quiet about it the whole way.
Yeah,
there's 23 degrees lower than what it is right now.
Yep. And it's actually pleasant right now.
Yeah. And then they had to make that trip and then get to the end and fight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, horrible. Ain't nothing like some that American spirit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, that was it in its truest form. Black people and white folks doing it together.
Yep, right.
Mind you, in those days, we were under the treason. We were committing treason.
Okay.
So, there you have it.
Yep.
Off the trunk.
Here we go. We are at Obelisk 7, and we're probably at this point 4 miles away from the battlefield, maybe, I think, probably around there. Anyway, right behind me is Hamilton Fitness Center, and I used to work out in this gym for a number of years, and it was owned by a good friend of mine I went to school with. But anyway, another time where I can remember seeing this thing out here and never really paying attention to it every time I went out. And you know, knowing that it had this strong connection to me, it's strange again now finding all this out now. But here we are, on to the next one.
Well, hi, and we're at this next lovely obelisk, and we found out just recently that over 3,000 women followed the Continental Army, following their husbands and helping them, and I find that very interesting, and I am honored to be on this march today. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, we're just coming up onto the
10th obelisk. And we're currently along the Delaware Raritan Canal. It's 505, and it's definitely starting to wear us out. We're all definitely on our, I guess, our last win here. Right. But we're going to make it. We're going to make it. Yeah, so we're at the 10th obelisk. It's about 5:15 in the morning. Sun should be up in about an hour and a half, and we're on schedule. Everything's going great, but it's starting to wear us out.
Yeah, and we're at the point now where our knees are humming and feet are hurting, and yet we still have it way better than what the Continentals had over 240 years ago.
Yeah, and Denise, how you doing over there?
Good, real good.
Starting to...
Real good, Tom. Yeah, last mile, right?
Yeah, so we're going to really stay focused. We got one more obelisk, and this thing is going to be over before we know it.
Yeah, this is the part where we dig deep.
Yep. Yeah.
This is where we, where our intestinal fortitude is tested.
Definitely.
And we have to, you know, we're always talking about completing the mission and being mission-oriented.
Yeah.
And it's right now, it's not convenient. And we have to be comfortable with being uncomfortable.
That's it. Wish us luck. Here we go, guys.
Yeah, embrace the
suck.
Amen.
Yeah. This is the 11th obelisk, and we're about 500 yards from our objective, which is the Princeton Battlefield. And we're concluding our movement. You know, we're looking at the last 500 meters, which is always the most critical part of the operation. You know, during this particular case, though, this battle, you know, the column, the Yanks kind of stretched out farther, and then the middle of the column engaged those enemies. So the column continued to move in. They didn't all just kind of follow in there. But anyway, that's another discussion for another time. We're right there. We did a great job. What do you think, Leo?
The whole thing about intestinal fortitude, you know, and digging deep and accomplishing the mission, you know, being mission oriented. We're going to be placing, we're going to be raising the standard and making demands of people. And so what this does is it gives us a level of credibility. So when we do make those demands, you know, we can point back to this and say, this is what we did.
You know, we wanted to motivate and we wanted to make people enthusiastic about being American. You know, and
yeah.
If it takes us coming out here and
you know. Walking 15 miles to, you know, how many people are willing to go that far for an idea? When's the last time you've been challenged like that? This is something that we're used to. We're used to we're comfortable with being uncomfortable. That's what this is. And backing up everything that we say with action. And so again, it gives us a level of credibility that a lot of people don't get when it comes to leadership.
Right. So anyway, we're going to finish out the mission here, and that's that. Thanks.
Yes. Very, very prominent.
Yeah.
All right.
Let's continue.
Okay.
So this is the 12th obelisk, and it's the final obelisk, correct?
Correct.
Yes.
And we've completed the mission, and right behind the camera is the Clark House, about 100 yards, and that is where the battle was kicked off, and within 15 minutes, the battle was over, and three of the King's finest regiments were broken because of this maneuver that we just did. And, you know, because of that maneuver, because of the battle and the victory of this battle, it propelled us forward in many ways, but essentially this enabled us to win the war.
Woo!
And Ezekiel Anderson, he was a rifleman and a militia, excuse me, he was a militiaman. And after this, shortly after this, he enlisted and he became a private. And he was a private in the Continental Army. And 4 years later, in 1781, he was with General Washington at Yorktown watching Cornwallis surrender.
Woo!
All right.
That must have been a really awesome experience to go through all that and then go down there and, you know, and I'm sure he probably was marching with the Continentals all over the Carolinas, you know, outmaneuvering Cornwallis. So just amazing stuff, and we're just happy to be a part of it. God bless America.
Amen.
Well done.
Amen.
Thanks.